Jerick McKinnon was a first All-Southern Conference selection in college, a third-round pick of the Vikings back in 2014, and our player resume brought to you by Indeed. Find the high-impact hire your business needs at Indeed.com/high-impact. And on that tip, we welcome in Jerick McKinnon, who is now playing for the San Francisco 49ers and found the end zone. Jerick, good morning. For the first time in about 1,000 days on Sunday, for people that don't know your story, you missed back-to-back seasons, complete seasons, had an ACL injury. What was it like to get there after 1,000 days in the end zone for your first touchdown after everything you've overcome?
A relief just to be able to know that I'm going to wake up and play a game on Sunday. But, it was a long process. I had to trust in the process, keep grinding it out, after the back-to-back surgeries, and, just come out there and give it my all my first time.
Jerick, when you look back at everything that went on at MetLife on Sunday, what do you think about that turf?
It's not the best playing surface. There's a lot of injuries, especially on our team. They had some injuries as well. So, it's just one of those things. It's kind of hard. You're out there warming up, and you could feel how bad the turf is. And then the game kicks off, and then you see guys going down. Back to back to back. It's very unfortunate. So. And I guess it's just one of those things that, you just got to adapt to, but definitely not the best playing surface.
With Mostert and Coleman out this week, possibly, likely out, and you got to carry the load and get prepared, moving from the third back up basically to the one back, what goes into your preparation in that mindset?
I'm not really sure the status of those guys, but, my preparation stays the same. Whether it's third, second, first, one rep, 10 reps, 20 reps, doesn't matter. So, I'm focused. I'm locked in as usual. And, whatever happens, happens, but I'll be ready regardless.
Jerick, Jay Williams here. First off, man, I commend you for going through the therapy that you went through. Battling back from knee injuries are challenging.
Appreciate it.
So much love and respect on that. But psychologically, as you see all these guys go down and you're going back to this same stadium, how do you psychologically get yourself ready for that?
Me personally, I've already been through a lot. I've already been through, the worst of the worst. So, I'm not really paying attention to it too much. Like I said, they're not the best. So, you don't, after seeing a lot of injuries, you hope that they can do something about it just for the safety of, everybody playing in the game. But, for me, kill is kill. I'm on a mission personally, so I'm ready.
Being on that mission, let me ask you this, man. There's a lot of controversy, obviously, and conversations that are going out there. You're going to keep it 100 with me right now. Should running backs – now, that's real. These running backs are falling – they're falling like flies, right? Whether it's McCaffrey injured, whether you look at a Saquon Barkley injured, whatever the case may be, should running backs still be valued from an economic standpoint, paying them long-term?
Yeah, definitely. Like I said before, it's unfortunate with the injuries, but, all those backs, they run the ball, they catch the ball, pass protect so much that the running back position, does individually. So I don't think, just because the injuries, are happening that they should be devalued. There's a lot that, a running back can bring to the game, especially one who can do more than one thing that's versatile. So, I think, we still should be valued and continue to get paid down the road.
We're talking to Jerick McKinnon of the 49ers. Lastly, Jerick, what's it like being a running back in a guy like Kyle Shanahan and the creative offense he brings to the table?
I just think it's just fun. The way he's able to, make matchups and mismatches, create those mismatches. And, he's a mastermind, definitely a wizard when it comes to the play calling. So definitely fun being in the offense. Personally me, my third year in the system, but first year playing, it's just a lot of fun. He knows the game so well. It's ridiculous. And, he's not just out there calling plays, it's setting up for something down the road. So, it's been fun. I've been enjoying it. I'll continue to enjoy it.
That's great stuff. His father is a two-time Super Bowl winning coach in Mike Shanahan, and obviously you guys went to the Super Bowl a year ago. See if you can get over the top. Super Bowl 55, and as Jay referenced, you'll be right back at MetLife. After taking on the Jets, you'll take on the Giants, so stay careful, stay safe on that field, and congratulations on an amazing return to the National Football League and getting back into that end zone. Thank you so much.
Go get that money.
Yeah, yes, sir. I appreciate that, man.
Facts 100.
Thank you, Jerick.
All right.
Great stuff. And we finally opened him up. There you go. All he had to do was talk about the money.
All
you
got to say money. It's going to get everybody excited.
It's almost like familiar voices.
Gotcha.
You start off with him, right? So you spook him as a journalist.
Right.
But when players start to engage, it's like, okay, cool. I think we'll be safe here.
Fair enough.
And he's a young guy, man. He'll be fine.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus right now.